This video will be about getting started to play saz or baglama, which is a Turkish instrument that is very nice and which you can also play together with guitar. So first of all, if you are interested in this instrument, first question to ask, which type would you like to buy? There are different sizes, and here I have, for example, three common sizes. The one I have here is a long neck baglama, and then there are also shorter versions, as the two I have here. So this one, the long neck, is tuned in A, while the other ones are tuned in C and in D. So the shorter versions are similar to this long neck, just that the neck is shorter, but you will get the one in C by placing a capo here on the third fret, and the one in D you can get by placing a capo here on the fifth fret. Therefore I would recommend to get the long neck baglama as the one I have here, because simply by placing a capo you will also have the other ones. While if you buy the short one, you can never obtain the long neck, so it's more flexible. Okay, and then with respect to the tuning that I am using, and which I believe is one of the most common, if not the most common, is baglama düzeni tuning. And here the top string is tuned in A, the middle strings in G, and the bottom strings in D. So for the top strings there are two strings an octave apart, the middle strings there are two strings the same, they're similar, and on the bottom, on the D, there are three strings, two a high octave and one a low octave. There are also other tuning systems, such as the black system. The black tuning, which is basically like a violin, that is G, D, A. But I'll play in the baglama düzeni tuning. And for the sake of this video, I think when you first start playing a new instrument, it's nice to play a melody that you already know. So I will play the Greek song misirlou, since this is very well known, and also because it goes in the hijaz scale, which is a very nice scale to play on baglama. One thing at first that is a little peculiar with the baglama tuning here is that you start a scale on the middle string. So the hijaz scale starts with an A here, and then a B here on the middle string, and then it goes to the top string on C sharp, and then D on the lower string, and then E, F, G, A. So it's A, B flat, C sharp, D, E, F, G, A. Yeah, so you can see that you have to start at the middle and then go to the top one, and then skip the string and go to the bottom one. This takes some time to get used to, but it makes a lot of sense once you start playing a lot of Turkish melodies. So for the first part of misirlou, it is actually G sharp that is used. Yeah. That is called shenas. Okay, so it goes like this. Okay, so first of all, there are some chords in here that are very nice to know. The main chord in düzeni tuning is like this. This is La, where you place your finger on the two bottom strings on the second fret here. So you have the upper, the top one, as an open string, like this. And this is a so-called power chord. It's only the E that is here. So it's A, A, E. So you can use this in both major and minor. If you want to turn it into a major chord, which was used in this scale, then you should have the C sharp up here. Then I made a small chromatic movement that is not in the original, but very often that is being played like this. When going to the B part. Here, that is D. That is also, you only have the finger on the middle string on the A, so this is only D A. So that's also a power chord that can be used both in major and minor. And then use this one. Here it's the same, but you take the F, so that is actually D minor. Then down here, this is A also, so we have A here, the octave higher, and then here you have E, same as here. So that's also an A. Then you may also notice that I was in playing like this. No, so here. So I was using this up here, that is the F here. So you can play the hijaz movement from here, from E, F, G sharp, A. So on the top string with your thumb, like. So you don't have to move your hand so much up and down. So this is only in the shinas part, where you have two hijaz pentachords. The first from A, A, E flat, C sharp, and D, and then from E. And you can play that from here. Yeah. Yeah. So this is a brief introduction to the hijaz scale, which is extremely nice to play on the baglama, and then also to the tuning, to the düzeni tuning, or the baglama düzeni tuning. I hope this is helpful.